Hello and welcome to another episode of the Top 3 Band Series. My name is Jos Appelboom and every Monday we post a new video about the personal top 3 bands of Bandfluencers. If you don't want to miss out on a video, subscribe to our YouTube channel now. A lot of people call themselves doctor when they have a lot of knowledge about something or when they can fix things. So when we first found out about Dr. Fountain Pens, we thought he was someone who fixes pens. But it turns out that Dr. Koshar not only knows a lot about fountain pens, he is actually a surgeon. So enjoy this very special top 3 and make sure you pay a visit to the Dr. Fountain Pens YouTube channel when you're done.
Hello all. Let me begin by saying that I am an ardent follower of Mr. Joost Appelboom's YouTube channel and I have a lot of respect and praise for his business establishment and their customer relations. A big thumbs up to them for what they're doing. When I was contacted by Appelboom for my top 3 pens, which have a story to tell, no doubt I was overjoyed. So I'm a doctor, practically a ENT surgeon, and I do have a YouTube channel with me with the name of Dr. Fountain Pens, on which I put my opinion regarding these wonderful writing instruments. And I do have a Instagram channel with the same name, and you can often find me squabbling with my other realistic self, Professor Korn, on occasion to occasion, and he's here with us. No, please go on by all means. It's your show. And just to tell you, he said 3, not 3. So you'd know who the sus is and who the real deal is. Okay, before things go out of hand, let me take control. What happened recently was that I had put my preferences of my top pens at my channel, but then that was something different. This series is about the pens which have some kind of a story which really connect with you in some way with the background. So that is what was very interesting, and that is how I am on board this particular series. It's I think really going to be very interesting. Just to tell you, you have to spend a lot of time with me every day, every minute. So if you try to ignore me, do it at your own peril. You can have your last word, okay? Please let me get rolling with this, okay? Let me at least put two of my choices, okay? Then we'll come to that. God. So let us begin by my first choice. So my first choice is the Waterman Careen. Now, in everyone's memory, you'd have a moment of your childhood when everything was pretty woozy. You couldn't recall the events. That was probably when you were aged 3 or less, and then some bits of information started to fall, and then the moment you are in grade kindergarten or grade 1 or 2, and then suddenly dollops of knowledge and recollection of events start to occur. Those are certain watershed moments when everything you start to remember about particular things. So Careen was my watershed in my memory of fountain pens, because to be honest, prior to this, I don't really recall the kind of pens or my experiences with fountain pens, because back in grade, prior to grade 6, because of certain compulsions at my educational institute or because of limitations of not being able to procure a fountain pen properly in the market, we had to actually settle for other writing instruments. So by the time I finished my graduation, I got going, I came into practice. That was when things started getting more interesting for me as regards fountain pens. Now, I remember going to malls with my better half while she was looking and window shopping and doing other stuff. I used to spend a lot of time in bookstores looking at the pen displays, and I could oogle at this for countless hours. I could go on and on looking at this pen, trying it out. And what hit me really hard was the whole design of the pen, the smooth curves, the capping mechanism, the silver cap, and this beautiful inlaid nib with two horns on the sides. And this became my everyday carrier for a long, long time, until the proverbial problem of the Careen struck, And then when it started leaking from the side of the inlaid nib, then I had to again put it away, and I fell out of using fountain pens for quite a long time once again, until I came across the fountain pen groups, and I became acquainted with certain YouTube channels on fountain pens, and which again rekindled my enthusiasm about this. And then came the second one, which is Pelican Ocean Swirl. Now this was my first big budget international purchase. I usually didn't buy things on such a big scale, on such a big budget, and from international sellers. So this was the first pen which I bought, and it was from Goulet. And I was really besotted with the appearance, the looks, and the phenomenal performance of this pen. I was so overjoyed with this that I wanted to share my experience, and that's how my YouTube channel started. Actually, this was the pen with which I started my YouTube channel, and after that, whenever I used to acquire my pens, whether I liked them or disliked them, I used to share it with the viewers and put my opinion about why I would rate this highly or why I wouldn't. So that's the story behind my second pen. Now, before I spend even a minute on myself, I'll just stop here. And that's not a favor you're doing to me. Okay, so I'll tell you my story behind the pen. I'm not trying to cheat by showing you three pens, but I'll tell you how they are connected with the final story. And this is the Metropolitan. So what happened that for a long time I was addicted to buttery smooth nibs, the one with the lot of tipping, and how they wrote on paper smooth without any hint of feedback and everything. And then I tended to acquire a lot and lot of pens which were very unnecessary, and it kept piling on in my storage, and my pen storage was bursting at its seams, and I had a very unhappy wife and an accountant to whom I just couldn't justify. And then I happened to purchase Pilot Metropolitan in medium nib, and when I wrote with it, I cursed my decision of buying this pen. I hated how the nib wrote, the line width, and the feedback, and everything about it, and I could call it names, and how I cursed myself for this purchase. And then I sort of gave it up. Then I wanted to acquire a safety pen, so I went on eBay and acquired this this safety pen, which was all broken parts and untuned nib, which did not write properly. This is just Excelsior safety pen. But then Mr. Syamak Zaidi, he's based out of Mumbai in India, and then he came to my rescue. He's our pen angel, who makes our bad choices about vintage pens right by tuning our and mending our pens. Big thanks to him for what he's doing. He did something with the tuning of the nib and set it with a kind of a stub feedback in nib, which really changed something in the tactile centers of my brain. And I really liked all the feedback on the pens and the nibs, which I used to hate earlier, and those now became my four most favorite possessions. I did away with all the junk that had accumulated with me, some of the things which I didn't like, I gave them up, and I settled for a really new kind of a journey in the fountain pen world, in my personal world. And that's when I acquired a Pilot Metropolitan, which was a step further in that decision. And this has become one of my favorite pens, everyday carry, on writing on any kind of a paper. So the eye-opening revelation for me that was that many a times it's not that the things for that matter, even the people, are good or bad. It's how they align with our preferences. Now, at one point of time, we may be hateful of them, the articles or the people, but certain subtle change of perspective or certain rewiring of our neurons, and those things become dear to us. So now I've started to reserve my judgment about things and people. as they say in judicial circles. That was my third pen with a story piece.